It was just kind of weird. But another thing is people arguing about the title, because I said no, a digital clock with no electronics. If you're so, oh, there's a circuit board in there. There's resistors. There's electronics. It's electronics. Okay, so no, there is a difference between electronics and electrical. For instance, I'm a member of the IEEE. IEEE. The IEEE stands for the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. It used to be IEEE, and then when active electronics really refers to active components, valves, amplifiers, transistors, active switching, as opposed to passive electrical stuff. A clock like that, with resistors and neon lamps and a motor going around, it's really considered to be passive. There's no amplifiers in it. There's no valves switching on and off. There's no transistors switching on and off. There's no processor. There's no active logic in it. It's electromechanical. So there's no electronics in it. Presence of resistors doesn't make something electronics. It's passive, electrical, like a toaster. A toaster is basically just a switch, a bimetal switch, some latches, and a big resistor, being the heating coils. You wouldn't call a toaster a piece of electronics. It's electrical. The clock is the same way. The other thing is, as many dozens of people have commented, yes, when I opened it up, I said, "Oh, is that a universal motor?" Just because when I open something up, I'm just saying whatever is in my mind. So yes, obviously it's an AC synchronous shape hold motor, but I probably should have edited that out, my ramblings. But for whatever reason, I didn't just edit that out. And so people have put, yeah, no, that's not a universal motor. That's a shape hole motor. That's an AC synchronous motor. Of course, it's AC synchronous. It's When I make a video, I typically put it up on Patreon first, so the patrons get it for at least a day. If I make like a really glaring mistake in something, or if I miss and I don't catch it in the editor, if it just goes by me in the editing process and it gets baked in when it's encoded, when I process it, if the patrons don't catch it, I just put it up as is. So it's one of those things where I kind of depend on my patrons to be proofreaders. I think the thing is, though, very few patrons, it's like a 5% of my patrons actually watch the video that I put up on Patreon. It's like 5-7% of the patrons actually will watch the video, the preview of the video. So I don't really get a big audience like for like proofreading on Patreon. I wish more patrons would watch the preview rather than waiting for the premiere, just so that if there's something in there you want to add, or you think that I should have added or said, or something is wrong, or if I misspell something in one of the titles, which also happens, and I have to go and re-edit it and put it up, that I don't, once I actually make it live on YouTube, I'm committed to it. You can't edit it after it's up. It's so. But yeah, it's just one of those things. But yeah, the electrical versus electronics argument. And also a lot of people commenting saying, oh, that's an analog computer, that's analog electronics. Well, I technically no. Digital does not mean that transistors are used. And if you have a computer that doesn't use transistors, that it's automatically analog. Analog computing is basically means that any value can have an infinite number of possibilities in an analog computer. So, but if every bit bit is either one value or another, is binary, it's digital. Even though it's electromechanical, it is digital. It's encoding digital information. Every lamp is either on or off. There's no intermediate states. It's not supposed to be any intermediate states. So it would be digital, just not active digital. Very interesting.
In the lab. That's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. In my lab. That's where I work. I'm Fran.